Hello, I'm Fabio Patrizzi from Sapienza University of Rome. I present the work High Level Programming via Generalized Planning and LTL Synthesis, co-authored with Blaise Bonnet, Giuseppe De Giacomo, Hector Geffner, and Sasha Rubin. This paper deals with transformational programs, which are programs that manipulate finite data structures to reach a desired configuration from an initial one. A representative example could be sorting an array of integers. This is different than reactive synthesis, where programs designed to carry on a continuous interaction, such as servers, are obtained. We have considered transformational programs that manipulate standard data structures, such as lists, graphs, or trees. We address the following problem. Given formal specification of a data structure and execution requirements, automatically synthesize a program that satisfies the execution specification by manipulating the data structure using only its functions. The contributions are the following. First of all, we propose a deductive and semi-automated approach to support design and implementation of transformational programs. Second, we devise a technique for the automated synthesis of programs which guarantees correctness. This is based on a reduction of the problem to an advanced form of generalized planning, which is then solved using LTL reactive synthesis. Notice that we do not propose a fully automated approach to the synthesis of programs from an input-output specification. We do a form of high-level declarative programming, but our specifications talk about program executions, not data configurations. Let's see an example. We want to synthesize a program that finds the minimum in a list, given a library implementing list. A pointer, initially on the leftmost cell, allows for scanning the list from left to right. To model value-returning functions, we assume the library provides a register able to store one value. On the left-hand side, you have a possible implementation. The library is in Python, but the language is not important. There are three operations. Write, which moves the pointer right by one position, update register, which copies the currently pointed element to the register, and stop, a predefined action modeling the end of computation. The library provides also two tests, less than, to check whether the current element is less than that in the register, and at end, to check if the pointer has reached the last element. On the right-hand side, there is a corresponding high-level specification. This is not in a formal language, but could be easily written in some. As we'll see, its formal version will be needed at synthesis time. Notice that there is a one-to-one correspondence between high and low-level operations and tests. Thus, high-level calls can be easily transformed into concrete ones. We want to automatically generate a high-level program that finds the minimum and manipulates the list using only library functions. The ultimate goal is to transform the program into an executable. However, this is straightforward, and we won't enter the details. Notice that, at synthesis time, the input list is unknown, and knowledge about its structure and content can be obtained only through tests and operations. For example, the program can know that the pointer is on the last element by either performing at end or by recording that it has seen the end in the past. Partial knowledge about the input list gives also rise to non-determinism in operations. For example, after moving right, the pointer may or may not end up at the end of the list. In general, the program we want to synthesize has the form of a finite state controller over the data structure. Notice that, in this example, but also in general, the goal is not observable. Indeed, we cannot check whether the minimum element is currently pointed at. This fact can be known only as an indirect consequence of program execution and observations. Synthesis of transformational programs is related to generalized planning, which is the problem of finding a single plan that is successful for a possibly infinite set of planning domains. Let me briefly introduce this setting. In generalized planning, instances are sets of planning domains which share some actions and observations. For instance, you can write one distinct planning domain for every possible list to capture their dynamics, and then put them together to obtain a generalized planning instance. Since the planning domains can be infinitely many, in practice they are never written separately. Rather, a finite representation of the whole set is typically used. Although these instances have common actions and observations, they produce different execution traces. For example, in a list of size 3, the end is reached after 3 moves right, while more steps are needed for size 5. The task of generalized planning is to find a single plan that is goal-reaching in all planning domains. Obviously, the plan can use only common actions and observations. Two important features characterize generalized planning. First, the goal is reachability, and there are no temporal requirements. Second, the goal is observable. In fact, it is a formula over the observations.
We'll see that these features constitute two major limitations in capturing and solving syntheses for transformational programs. Generalized planning is typically solved by reduction to fully observable non-deterministic or fond planning. Indeed, a fond planning domain can capture the observational abstraction of the domains in a generalized planning instance. The observational abstraction is a representation of all the planning domains in the instance, and as a consequence of the uncertainty over the concrete instance, is typically non-deterministic. In fond planning, non-determinism is fair, essentially meaning that by repeating an action over and over, all of its effects eventually occur. For example, since lists are finite, by moving right over and over, the pointer eventually reaches the end. A solution to the generalized planning problem is a policy, which is a mapping from fond states to actions. Solution policies are strong cyclic solutions, that is, they are goal-reaching on fair traces, while may not be such on unfair ones. Intuitively, a solution can take advantage of fairness. By fairness, for instance, we can reach the end of a list by simply moving right until the end. Fairness cannot be modeled with non-determinism alone, and in fond planning is assumed. Generalized planning has some similarities with synthesis of transformational programs. First, they're conceptually analogous, as both search for a solution that works for a possibly infinite set of instances. Second, both deal with a set of planning domains. I haven't shown it, but it's immediate to come up with a planning domain for list. There are also crucial differences. In program synthesis, the goal may be not observable, as in the running example where we cannot test whether the pointed element is minimum. Second, as already pointed out, the goal is not reachability. Finally, the controller for program synthesis is in general stateful, not just a policy. As a result, generalized and fond planning are not powerful enough to solve the synthesis problem for transformational programs. We can, however, devise an approach inspired by generalized planning. Since the goal is not observable, we must guarantee in an indirect way that it's reached by the controller. To this end, we can put requirements on executions. These requirements must be temporal, as executions are sequences. Now, the trick is to include the requirements in the goal so that they're satisfied by the synthesized controller. Notice that this rules out generalized planning as a solution approach, because the goal is no longer reachability. This is an example of execution requirement in pseudologic. It says that the controller always updates the register if and only if the pointed element is less than the content of the register. It's immediate to see that if the controller satisfies this requirement, when the end of the list is reached, the register contains the minimum. Thus, it is sufficient to require that the controller reaches the end and satisfies the requirement to obtain the desired controller. Of course, execution requirements are not automatic, nor simple to obtain. They require significant effort by the designer, possibly comparable to writing the program. However, by proceeding in this way, the designer can avoid dealing with implementation details and focus on the solution logic only. Also, bugs can due only to the solution logic, not implementation details. In short, we obtain the advantages of high-level programming. I've mentioned that fond is unable to find stateful solutions. For this, we can resort to LTL reactive synthesis, which consists in generating a controller that satisfies an LTL specification. Since the controllers are stateful, if we can encode transformational program synthesis into LTL, we can resort to LTL synthesis for the solution. It turns out that this is the case. We can capture a fond planning domain, together with fairness assumptions and temporal goals, as an LTL synthesis problem. The paper shows that the LTL specification for transformational program synthesis has this form. Here, pre-captures the preconditions of the observational abstraction, which can be computed almost systematically from the library. F captures the action effects, the frame axioms, and the initial state, and also this is almost systematic. FAIR models the fairness assumptions. This is not systematic and can be complex to write, but often comes directly from natural observations. For instance, in the running example, FAIR captures the fact that action right eventually reaches the last element. Finally, goal. It includes execution requirements and reachability goals. This is not systematic and typically hard. Writing the goal formula requires designer creativity and a significant effort. Goal is the core of the specification. This is a high-level LTL specification of the Python list library. Pre says that right can be executed only if not at end, that only one action can be executed at a time, and that stop is final. F says that after updating the register, the current element is not less than the register content, and that the pointer doesn't move. Of course, stop doesn't change the state. Fair says that moving right over and over eventually takes the point to the end. And finally, Gall says that the end of the list is reached and that whenever the current element is less than the register content, the register is updated. We've implemented the whole approach. This is an encoding of the LTL specification into the input language for Strix, which is an LTL synthesis engine developed at the Technical University of Munich and available on the web. The controller at the bottom is the corresponding Strix output. As expected, the controller scans the list while updating the register content whenever the current element is smaller. The controller can be easily turned into an executable program. On the left, you have the Python program generated from the controller. The program uses only operations and tests from the list library. On the right, I have reported some runs. This picture summarizes the main steps of the approach, which is shown in the bottom part. The essential difference with respect to generalized planning is that now we can explicitly model fairness and add execution requirements. As we've seen, this is sufficient to capture and solve synthesis of transformational programs. We show that the approach can be successfully applied to a number of data structures and problems. This is a list of all the problems we tested. The solution time is always less than 10 seconds. Performance, however, were marginally important at this stage, as the primary goal was to show feasibility of the approach. To conclude, we have proposed a deductive approach to program synthesis that offers correctness guarantees. The approach is semi-automated. In particular, it requires creativity to formalize the fairness assumptions and the goal. The designer effort can be comparable to that for solving the problem in a traditional way. However, this is paid off by a number of advantages. First, the designer can focus on the solution logic only and completely neglect the implementation details. Second, bug sources are confined inside the fairness assumptions and the goal. Finally, a program specification is produced which is amenable to reasoning in general, not only synthesis. For instance, it could be model checked to analyze the controller behavior on specific inputs. For future work, two directions can be followed. The first concerns scalability, which could be improved by adopting planning approaches for problems specified in LTL over finite traces. The second concerns modularity, that is, the possibility of combining data structures and problem specifications to produce more complex problems, possibly of practical interest. For instance, minimum in a list is defined by adding execution requirements to list or versa. It would be interesting to investigate this aspect. And this is all. Thanks for your attention.